In this video, we are going to learn about proof by induction, which is a very powerful method of proving statements. And in fact, you will see that it can be used to not just prove one statement, but infinitely many statements all at once. I like to compare it to climbing a staircase because it's very similar of going up a staircase step by step. So let me state what our aim is. Our aim is to prove a statement for all natural numbers that are greater than or equal to some fixed natural number n sub zero. So we have a statement for each natural number capital N greater than or equal to n zero. And the way we are going to prove it, the proof method consists of three steps. And this is what I like to compare to climbing a staircase, because the first step in this proof by induction is to establish a base case. This means that we have to show or prove that the statement is true for, let's say, the first number n sub zero. So this is establishing the base case. And if you think of a staircase, just to go with this analogy, imagine an infinite staircase, a staircase with infinitely many steps, and you would be standing here at the bottom of the staircase, being very happy because you're doing maths. And your aim is to climb this staircase, so to go from step number one to step number two to step number three and so on to step number n, then the next one, step number n plus one. And the way you do it, if you are a mathematician, is first you show that you can make the first step. So let me actually refer to this base case as make the first step. Okay, next in the proof method, we have the what's called the induction hypothesis. Which is to assume that the statement is true for some n. So we are assuming that the statement is true for some unspecified natural number n. Okay, well, it should be greater than or equal to n sub zero, but it's very important that we do not specify which n. We are just assuming that there is such a little n for which the statement is true. And we know that this is not an empty statement. This is what the base case was for. So we have a firm ground to stand on. So we have such an n, and we are assuming that we are taking an n like that. And once we have that, okay, let me just say that this means that we imagine you made it to step n, which we do not specify which step it is. It could be up here, but it could be the first one. The point is it's not specified, but we imagine, we assume that we made it there. And in our last step of the proof, we make the induction step. So the induction step means that we show, prove that, well, exactly how, well, we have to using step two, meaning the induction hypothesis, that the statement is true, for the next number as well, n plus 1. So in the induction hypothesis, we assume that it is true for some n, and in the induction step, we are proving that it is going to true, is it going to be true for the next number as well, using that assumption in step 2. Okay, I would say that we should use the staircase analogy, then I would say show that you can go from step n to step n plus 1. Okay, so I hope this made sense, and now you understand how this proof method works in general, and now I would like you to consider an example. Let us consider our first example for proof by induction. This will be about triangular numbers, and in case you don't know what a triangular number is, it's the number of dots that you need to build a equilateral triangle shape. So let me give you a triangular number. Well, this is the first triangular number, and it contains, it's one, it contains only one dot. Well, we also get a triangular shape like this. The second triangular number is 3, because we need 3 dots. The third triangular number is 6. You can see that it for each new row, we have to increase the number of dots in that row by 1. So for the fourth triangular number, we have to add 4 to the previous number of dots. Okay, so these are triangular numbers, and our first example is about them. We are going to prove a proposition which basically will tell us what is the nth triangular number. So for all natural numbers, capital N in the set of natural numbers, we have the following. Well, remember how we built this triangle up? We had to take one dot, we had to add 2 dots to that, 3 to that, and we had to keep doing it till the nth row. So we have to basically calculate this sum, and our proposition says that this sum is equal to n times n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so let us prove this proposition using mathematical induction. So our proof starts with establishing a base case. So the base case, remember, this means checking that the formula, well, the statement is true for the first case, which would be n equals 1. So check if it's true for capital N equals 1. Well, let's see. then we are only adding up one term, which is just the number one on the left hand side, and on the right hand side we have 1 multiplied by 1 plus 1 divided by 2. So this is in fact 1 times 2 divided by 2, which is equal to 1. So this means that we have established the base case. This is the first step done. So for our next step, we have to make the induction hypothesis. Which means we have to assume that the statement is true for some natural number. And again, let me just underline that we are assuming it to be true for some n, without specifying which one. We know that there is already one number for which it is true, so it's not an empty statement. So we assume this, and then we move to the induction step. Our final step in the proof, which means we have to show that it's true for n plus 1 as well. And we have to show this using step 2, the induction hypothesis. Okay, so let's see what it means to what the statement is for n plus 1. Well, it means that we have to consider the sum 1 plus 2 plus 3 all the way to n plus 1. Well, before that we have the nth term, n itself, then the last term, n plus 1. And what I'll do with this sum is I separate the sum into two parts. I'll consider the first n terms, because I want to use the induction hypothesis, which is about the statement for little n, and that is exactly the sum about which the statement in step 2 was assumed to be true. And then we have the last term, n plus 1, but if I apply the induction hypothesis, so induction hypothesis, step 2, to the first n terms, I will get n times n plus 1 divided by 2, so n times n plus 1 over 2, plus the last term, n plus 1 itself. I can, of course, make it so that they have a common denominator. That would mean having n times n plus 1 over 2 plus twice n plus 1 over 2. And then I can just basically collect the terms multiplying n plus 1. So if I do that over here, so I collect the terms multiplying n plus 1, and these terms are where here I have an n, and here I have plus 2. So n plus 1 is multiplied by n and plus 2, and this is all divided by 2. And if you look at this last formula, it is exactly of this form, with capital N replaced by little n plus 1. So this shows that the statement is in fact true for n plus 1 as well, and we use the induction hypothesis. So this concludes the entire proof. Let me say that this concludes the proof, and we have shown, we usually use this symbol to denote the end of proof, and we have shown that the nth triangular number is n times n plus 1 over 2. This sum is equal to that product. So before we end this video, I would like to test your knowledge. So again, let me ask you a question. My question is, what is the sum of the multiples of 7 between 1 and 100? So let me just help you with this. So I'm looking at multiples of 7, like 7, 14, 21, and so on, all the way to a multiple of 7 that is less than or equal to 100. And I will help you with even that. So that number is 98, and I'm asking you to calculate this product as quick as you can. So pause the video and input the answer in the box below, and I will tell you my solution after you have solved it. Okay, so I hope you have noticed that what we have here is, well, multiples of 7, and if we collect the numbers multiplying 7, well, we have a triangular number here, and exactly what we have is the 14th triangular number multiplied by 7, and for that number we already have this nice formula. The 14th triangular number is basically, so this will be 7 times 14 multiplied by 15, 14 plus 1 divided by 2. We can simplify this product, this fraction by 2. This leaves us with a 7, so we have 7 times 7 times 15, which is 49 times 15, which is almost the same thing as 50 times 15, but we have to subtract 115 from that, so that leaves us with 735 as the final answer. I'll see you in the next one.